Hey, Math 3 honors. Guess what? We're back. Okay. Here we go. We're going to start some trigonometry. Okay, this is a new chapter. So we're going to do some basics here. You know? Do some basic special right triangles. You guys already know how to graph a special right triangle, so go ahead and get your papers out, get your pencils out, get your books out. We do not need graph paper today. We do not need a calculator. Just pencil and paper, right? It's all review. You know how to do this. You know how to do it already. So let's just get to it. You know what I mean? Use my orange pen today. Woo! Purple. Red. Special right triangle. Right? See those? 30, 60, 90. 45, 45, 90. Okay? You guys got to pay attention because this is a completely new chapter that I've never shown you how to do this, and I'm doing it virtually. We're not in the classroom. We're doing virtual learning. If you have any questions, write them in the comments. Okay? Let's do this thing. Here we go. Okay. We're going to be doing special right triangles today, okay? Nothing, you should have done this in Math 2, but this is all review. So, special right triangles. If you don't like the way I teach it, look it up on YouTube. There's a lot of resources there. Special right triangles. You can also look up 45, 45, 90, or 30, 60, 90 triangle, okay? So, the idea behind this is, let's look at the 30, 60, 90 triangle first, okay? Now, if you're given one side based on the Pythagorean theorem, one side of the 30, 60, 90 triangle, you should be able to identify, find the measurements of all the sides of the triangle. Now, think of it this way. This is my 30, so this is my shortest leg. This is my 60, this is my longest leg. And this is my hypotenuse. Now, if you're given this in terms of x, the 30, that means if you multiply x by the square root of 3, you will get the longest leg. It'll be x times the square root of 3. And if you go here, if you multiply x by 2, okay, you'll get the length of the hypotenuse by saying 2 times x. Okay? But then the other way works too. So if I'm given the hypotenuse and I want to find the 30, the shortest leg, guess what? I divide by 2. And if I'm given the 60, and I want to find the shortest leg, or the 30, then I also, this side I multiply by square root of 3. So this I'm going to divide by the square root of 3. Okay, so think of it in terms of that way. So let's go ahead and do easy stuff first, okay? So this will be easy. Let's say I'm given the 30, and let's say that the 30 is 3. Okay? That's my shortest leg. So now to find my 60, okay, I just multiply this times the square root of 3, and I get 3 times the square root of 3. To find my hypotenuse, I multiply my shortest leg, or my 30, times 2, and I get 3 times 2, which is 6. Okay? So now, it doesn't matter how it is oriented. Let's look at this right here. Let's say I'm given my 30 again. Let's say my 30 is 8. Okay, well now to find my 60, I multiply my 30 times the square root of 3, and I say 8 times the square root of 3. And to get my hypotenuse, I multiply my 30 times 2, and 8 times 2 is 16. But let's say I'm given the... Now, even though this is, has a square root of 3, it doesn't mean this always has a square root of 3 and my answer. I can just multiply this times the square root of 3. So, let's say I'm given the 60 as, let's say my 60 is 8, I already did 8, let's say it's 10 times the square root of 3. There, see, it's my 60, my longest leg. So to find my shortest leg, which one's that? Well, my shortest leg is going to be over here. So to figure that out, I have to divide by the square root of 3. So I'm going to say to go this direction, to go that, to find my 30, I need to divide by the square root of 3. And so it's going to be 10 root 3 divided by the square root of 3. That goes away, and it'll be 10. Now that I have that, I can find my hypotenuse, and I can multiply by 2, and I can get 20. Okay? Okay, now let's look at this problem here, okay? This is very interesting. Let's solve for all the sides of this triangle. I'm given the 60, but there's no square root of 3 in there. That's fine. What do we need to do to figure out the 30 side? Well, remember we said we divide by the square root of 3. So I'm going to write this as 4 divided by the square root of 3. Okay? So then this side is going to be 4 divided by the square root of 3. The problem is I cannot have the denominator as the square root of 3. So I have to get rid of that square root of 3. And the way we do that is you multiply this by the square root of 3, and you must, for any fraction, if you multiply the denominator by the one number, you also have to multiply the numerator by that number. Okay? So to get rid of the square root of 3, I gotta multiply by root 3 over 3. Okay, what's root 3 times root 3? Well, that's root 9. This is 4 times root 3 is 4 root 3. Root 9 is just 3, and so it's 4 root 3 over 3, and that's going to be this side right here. 4 root 3 over 3, right? So in order to get rid of that, we multiply top and bottom by root 3, and we get 4 root 3 over 3. Now I can solve for my hypotenuse, right? And the way I do that, remember I multiply my 30 times 2. So now I have 4 root 3 over 3 times 2. Okay, so how do you multiply fractions by whole numbers? Well, I just multiply numerator times numerator, denominator times denominator. 4 times 2 is 8 root 3 over 3. And that'll be my hypotenuse. 8 root 3 over 3. Okay? That's as hard as it's going to get. Let's try another one like that. Okay, but remember, to get this, I divide by root 3 and I get that. Then I have to multiply this by 2 to get that. By the way, if you multiply this by root 3, you can fast forward through this if you want, but I should be able to multiply this by root 3 and get 4. What happens if I multiply 4 root 3 over 3? Well, let's multiply that times root 3. What's root 3 times root 3? It's just 3. And 3 times 1 is 3, and you cancel them out and you get the 4. So it does work out. If I multiply this by root 3, I will get 4. Anyway, let's do another one. Okay, so here we go. Here I have this 30, 60, 90 triangle used for reference. Remember, now what am I given here to solve for this? Okay, this is the hypotenuse. Go ahead and pause and see if you can figure out the rest of the other sides, okay? Now remember the hypotenuse, whoa, this embarrassing. I wrote all of this wrong here. Sorry. This should be x times the square root of 3. And this is 2 times x. Sorry, I had to fix that. Use that as a reference. Hopefully you said, oh, Sensei, you made a mistake there. Well, you fixed it. Okay, so now, if I'm given my 30, I multiply by the square root of 2 to get my hypotenuse. But then to go the other way, to get my 30, once I have the hypotenuse, I divide by 2. Okay, so I have my hypotenuse. My 30 is right here. So what's, to solve it, I do 8 divided by 2, which is corazón, sorry. That's 4. Now that I can figure out my 30, right? Now that my 30 is x, to figure out my 60, I multiply the square root of 3, and I get 4 root 3. Hopefully you got all that. Okay, try to solve for all the missing sides of this right triangle. Pause and try to do it on your own. Notice I'm giving you the 60, right? So to solve for the 30, I gotta divide by the square root of 3, and then multiply this times 2 to get the hypotenuse. So pause and go ahead and do that. Okay, to find the 30, I take my 9 and I have to divide by the square root of 3. Okay, but I cannot have square root of 3 in the denominator. So I multiply by root 3, numerator and denominator. 9 root 3 over root 3 times root 3 is square root of 9. Square root of 9 is 3. Now look here. 9 divided by 3, I can simplify that, and this becomes 3 times the square root of 3. And there is my 30. Okay? Now, to get the hypotenuse, I multiply the 30 times 2. Right? And I get 6 root 3. And that's all you got to do. Okay, one more I want you to try. Go ahead and try to pause and solve this on your own. I'm giving you the hardest one because I'm giving you the 60, right? So to solve for the 60, to solve for the 30, I got to take the 60, divide by root 3. So this is 12 divided by root 3, but remember, I can't have a square root in the denominator, so multiply root 3 by root 3, and that becomes root 3 times root 3 is root 9, square root of 9 is 3, 12 times square root of 3 is 12 times square root of 3, 12 and 3 are divisible by 3, and I get 12 divided by 3 is 4 root 3, and there is my 30. And then, of course, my hypotenuse is the 30 times 2. 4 times 2 is 8. That's it. Okay, so again, this is all review. So try and practice those on your own. Next, let's do a 45-45-90 triangle. Look at the 45-45-90 triangle. Alright? This is easier, I think. Now let's think about what's going on here from our geometry or math 2 classes and math 1. 45-45-90 is actually an isosceles right triangle. It means that this, since the angles are the same, the opposite sides are going to be congruent, or they're going to be the same length. So if this is x, well then, if they're the same length, then this will also be x. Now, to figure out the hypotenuse, you just take the x and you multiply it by the square root of 2 to get this side right here. So I say, hey, multiply that times the square root of 2. But to go in the other direction, to figure out this, if you're given the hypotenuse, to solve for the leg, or the 45 side, guess what? I'm going to divide by the square root of 2.
Okay, that'll be the most challenging part. But let's do one for the fun of it. So let's say we're given one side here. Let's say we're given this 45. Let's say we're given this 45, 45, 90 triangle. Let's say the side is 7. Okay, well, since I know that this is an isosceles right triangle, this side's going to be the same, then guess what? This side will also be 7. And then to figure out the hypotenuse, I just multiply the 45, or either this 45, doesn't matter which one, times the square root of 2, and this is 7 times the square root of 2. Now remember, the triangles can twist and turn around and all that stuff, but that's all you got to do right there. Let's do another one, shall we? Okay. So here's a 45, 45, 90. I'm giving you one side. One of the 45s is 8. Go ahead and pause and see if you can solve the other sides.
Okay. So if this is 8, well, these sides are congruent, so this is also 8. And my hypotenuse is going to be 8 times the square root of 2.
There you go. Okay. Now, here's another,
let's label this as a 45, 45, 90 triangle.
But now I gave you the hypotenuse as 10, okay? Well, even though there's no square root of 2 here, I know I can get this 45 right here by dividing by the square root of 2, right? If I go this, multiply the square root of 2, I divide by the square root of 2. But what's wrong with that? 10 divided by square root of 2? I cannot have the square root of 2 in the denominator. So you multiply the numerator and the denominator by 2. 2 times the square root of 2 is square root of 4. 10 times the square root of 2 is 10 root 2. What's the square root of 4? Well, guess what? Is 2. Basically, this becomes 2 right here. And 10 divided by 2 is going to be 5. So this side is 5 times the square root of 2. Well, what's this side going to be? It's going to be the same because it's isosceles. There you go. And guess what? If I multiply this times the square root of 2, I should get 10. What is 5 root 2 times root 2? Well, root 2 times root 2 is 2. 5 times 2 is 10. Okay, go ahead and see if you can solve the missing sides of this 45, 45, 90 triangle.
And we're given the hypotenuse, so I gave you a hard one. So, but in order to solve for the missing side, you take the hypotenuse and you divide by the square root of 2. Can't have the square root of 2 in the denominator, so root 2 times root 2 is root 4. We just leave it as 2. So this is 3 root 2 over 2. And since this is going to be the same, this will also be 3 root 2 over 2.
Let's do one more, shall we? Okay, go ahead and pause and see if you can figure this one out.
Again, to figure out the 45, I got to divide by the square root of 2. Can't have the square root of 2 in the denominator, so I multiply the numerator and denominator by the square root of 2. Root 2 times root 2 is 2. 18 divided by 2 is 9 root 2. So guess what? 9 root 2, 9 root 2.
I decided to do one more, so go ahead and see if you can solve that one real quick.
Try to do kind of an easy one. Pause it, solve it. So in order to solve for this, I gotta divide by root 2. You don't need to do this step because a lot of you already know. Sensei, why are you working this out? Well, root 2 divided by root 2 is 1, and we say that's just 10, which makes sense because 10 times square root of 2 equals 10 times square root of 2. All right, Math 3 honors, that's it. I just did some practice graphing special right triangles. If you know how to do that, you're good, but just make sure you can do the ones that I showed you. Okay, and then we'll just go ahead and start. Next lesson is graphing sine. Okay, we're gonna start getting to graphing sine, graphing cosine. It's based on all those special right triangles. All right, 30, 60, 90, 45, 45, 90 triangle. All right, you guys are awesome. Hang in there, stay safe. Sensei. Signing off.